quick reminder to please put your phone on vibrate. That would be my phone as well. Also, a quick little warning for anyone speaking up here. This mic has a very small tolerance of space of how far you need to be to hear yourself. This is about as far as you can go. Anything out there? So, yeah, please, Mr. Daniel, you're pretty tall, so I don't think you want to lean down. You probably want to grab the mic. Feel free to grab it. Donuts. We have donuts in the back and some water as well. We bought a lot of donuts. Let me go ahead and get some. And if anybody does get the chance, you look behind, you'll see a pool back here. If you cross over to another courtyard on the other side, we have a beautiful Japanese-style Asian garden here for the seniors. And my mom back there actually helps to take care of this really beautiful koi pond back there. We have a gazebo, there's a bridge over the pond, which is a beautiful picture if you ever get the chance to go over there and put the gazebo in the background. So you're more than welcome to. Just let y'all know. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming out today. My name is Mike Nguyen. I'm the executive director of Being Teamwork. We are a community-based nonprofit organization right here in Southwest Houston. I'd like to welcome everyone today to a very special roundtable discussion regarding the child tax credit. I'd also like to welcome everyone and thank you for coming out to one of our affordable housing communities, Golden Bamboo Village 3 Senior Apartments. You know, at Being Teamwork, one of our biggest programs that we have is partnering with the IRS for the Volunteer Income Tax Assistance Program, also known as VITA. This is a program where we can offer free tax services to the low-income and underserved communities with over 100 volunteers that come every single year for the last 25 years. Every single year they come to service the community. This also gives the Vietnamese community the opportunity to give back and say thank you to this great country, a country that fought alongside with us and allowed us the opportunity to be here 46 years ago and grow to what you see today. So because we do serve so many taxpayers every single year, that gives us a chance to meet so many families, learn their story, and that's why it's so important to us that the child tax credit is going into effect at such a difficult time for all these families. You know, with the pandemic this past year, we've heard from these families, so many families that lost businesses, lost their jobs, or got their hours cut down, you know, and with school starting up real soon, especially, at least here in Houston, a lot of schools are going back to in-person. So it could be a better time for the child tax credit to come for all these families to help them. You know, this is a time where it's going to help get school supplies, clothing, and of course, help put food on the table. So today, we are going to welcome, because we are blessed to have some of our country's greatest leaders here to discuss the child tax credit in our round table. Today we have Deputy Secretary of the Treasury, Wally Adeyemo, joining us from the White House. Of course, my good friend, Congressman Al Green, U.S. Representative of Texas District 9, Congresswoman Sylvia Garcia, U.S. Representative of Texas District 29. We also are joined by the IRS, we have Arlene Good, and from the United Way, Cornelius Blackshear. So thank you everyone, and please help me in welcoming Deputy Secretary, Mr. Wally Adeyemo. Thank you so much, Deputy Secretary. I would like to now welcome my good friend, Congressman Al Green of District 9. We are right here in his district of the Golden Valley Village. Please welcome Congressman Al Green.
Thank you very much, Michael. It's an honor to be with you. Let me make sure that we celebrate properly. This is a celebratory event. And I'd like to start by recognizing the fact that there are similar moments in time that impact the rest of time. 1935 FDR, Social Security, was a similar moment in time. Well, this child tax credit is a similar moment in time for this president. And I think President Biden deserves a big ovation for what he has done to make this possible. In Texas, for something like this, the region is stand. We want to stand and give a really, really big, big ovation. Let's hear greatness of a nation is not measured by the height of its buildings, not measured by the number of Nimitz aircraft carriers it might have. It won't be measured by the size of the army. The greatness of a nation is not going to be measured by how we treat people who live in the suites of life. The greatness of a nation is dependent upon how we treat people in the twilight of life when they're seniors, and in the dawn of life as children. Social Security was a great means by which a great nation was able to protect seniors in the twilight of life. This program, this tax credit program, is a great program that will help children at the dawn of life. We are a great nation. This is the empirical evidence of how great we are. And I am proud today to say that I support this effort by this president to take it into a number of years, but I also support the motion that we should make this credit permanent for all years. Let's make it permanent. I want to especially acknowledge someone, and if you'll allow me to do this, I think it's very important. Mr. Nguyen, who's here with us today, had a family trip planned. He was destined to be out of the state today. It was a lot. When he found out about the details of this program, Mr. Nguyen rearranged his family trip. This was a trip with children and the family dog as well. Literally. And he rearranged his trip so that he could be here for this most auspicious occasion. Mr. Nguyen really deserves a big expression of that some measure their lives by days and years, others by heart draws patches of tears, but the surest measure of the God's Son is what the others in your lifetime have you done. Thank you for what you're doing for children in your lifetime. Thank you so much. Present a certificate to you as well. Thank you so much, Michael, for what you're doing. God bless you. And please keep up the good work. Thank you very much. Thank you. And the United Way is here. And well, as the taxing authority, so if the two of you will come over, we'll present this to the two of you at the same time. And thank you, sir, for being here with us. We are greatly appreciative of what the United Way does, and thank you so much for continuing to do what we expect you to do, and that is to help our young people to make their way in life. Thank you. That having been said, since she's standing here with me, I will further introduce my colleague from the 29th Congressional District, who came to Congress with credentials par excellence, having served as a state senator, having served as the city comptroller, having served as a judge. She understands life from many points of view. Her perch now affords her the opportunity to help persons who are living not only in the sweets of life, but also in the streets of life, the Honorable Sylvia Garcia.
Be with you and all your friends, and welcome again to Houston and Texas, and we do want you back, and we're going to take you to the streets so that you can see firsthand what is happening with our families and our working people here in Houston. And thank you for inviting us and being such a great host, and I hope you have a good trip. Take care of that dog. But I just wanted to add just a few words because, you know, the congressman mentioned some of the things that I've done in my life. But I can tell you that the job that I love the most was just being a social worker, going to people's homes and visiting with them and trying to figure out what it was in their lives that we could do to make it better. And this program, this child tax credit, is about that. It's about making sure that we can take care of the children. Because in the end, that's really what it's all about for our mothers, for our parents, and for our families, is taking care of the children. You know, I grew up poor in South Texas. I'm one of 10 kids. And I can tell you that there was nothing my mother and father would not have done for the 10 of us. For the 10 of us. Everything they did was, if we say in Spanish, para nuestros hijos, for our children. And who does the primary caregiving when it comes to children? The mothers. So this is about helping the mothers, especially the mothers that are single heads of household, the mothers who have children that they've got to take care of and still try to go to work to pay the bills. And it's like the congressman said, it's not just about the doctors and the dentists and the school supplies and the school uniforms. It's about food on the table. It's about a roof over their head. It's about making sure that they have gasoline on the car to get to the job. So this program is about keeping and holding families together, focused on the children. And let me tell you, as an old social worker, this is one of the greatest programs since Social Security. Since Social Security. This is kind of like a Social Security for children. Okay? Who's, again, I'll repeat what the congressman said. We've sort of taken care of the seniors, and we'll never forget them, but we also have to take care of the little ones. Because in the end, that's really what it's all about. And I know all the mamas out there know that. And so many mamas, about 3 to 4 million women in this country, either lost their jobs or had to stay home to take care of their children, do the schooling, do everything, because someone had to do it when the school shut down. So mothers, this one's for you. I know it's not Mother's Day, but this one's for you. children. So I'm pleased to be here today, and just as a quick reminder, remember, everybody qualifies. If you didn't pay your income tax taxes yet, or if you didn't file your tax return, it doesn't mean you can't get it. There's a separate portal now, a separate place where you can go to sign on and say, you know, here's my social security number, and here are my children, and this is where you can send the check. So there's still time, and people here are set up to do that. So call your neighbors, text them, tell them to get out of their apartments and come sign up, because that's what this is all about. We need everyone signed up. In my district, 230,000 children qualify. 230,000. 95% of the children in my district qualify. And it would lift about half of them out of poverty. So please tell all your friends, if they didn't get a check yesterday, they can go online and sign up and figure out why they didn't get one, and they'll be told online what they need to do. So thank you again, Congressman, and I look forward to listening to all the stories. And I can tell you, this is the biggest program since Social Security. Thank you, President Biden.
Congresswoman Garcia, Congressman Al Green, and of course, Deputy Secretary, Mr. Adeyemo. Please give him a big round of applause one more time for being here. Before we enter our roundtable discussion, I'd like to welcome up someone really close to us that's worked in the IRS with us for the closing remarks. Please welcome Arlene Good.
Thank you all for your cooperation. As we move swiftly, the only rule is that as you speak, you're going to share your name. It's kind of why you're here today, and we will go around and have some honest conversation about this important benefit that we just mentioned. So many families here in the Great Nation. I want to start to my right and left. You would take a moment and introduce yourself to the group and tell us why you're here.
The child tax credit will benefit me. One, I have a 4-month-old, so I'm a new mom. I'm currently a college student as well, so I'm a full-time college student as well as a full-time mom. So I don't really have much time to have a full-time job. So me only having a part-time job is kind of difficult for me to bring in money in order for me to pay bills, pay for my college fees, and to also take care of my baby. He's growing really fast, so he's always needing something. Moms know babies always need something. So this tax credit will really, really help me and my son tremendously. It'll help me be able to get the development things that he needs. He's currently running out of diapers. We didn't get a lot of a baby shower. So I'm gonna, you know, have funds to get that for him as well. I'm also planning on going to nursing school, so that's gonna take a lot of change out of me as well. So with this, you know, tax credit, I'm really excited to be able to help myself and my son for the future, knowing that he's always gonna be set.
My name is Amelia Robinson, and I'm here to have a discussion about the benefits of the child tax credit. I have two kids. I have a son that's in high school and a daughter that's in elementary. And I just want to talk about the importance and the awareness, because I think right now a lot of people my age are not aware of how the child tax credit actually works and how it really can benefit them. So I hope after they actually watch and listen to the discussion that we have today, that they will be more educated and want to go online to accept the advanced child tax credit.
There's another parent who told me I agree, but they're keeping them on the process.
That's a little one.
Hi, I'm Sophia. I didn't budget for the pandemic. As a single parent, this has actually been answered prayer, because this has helped me take care of my financial responsibilities. I am also a frontline worker, so when daycares did shut down, my household changed, right? So everything went up. The light bill went up, the internet went up. So this additional money is actually going to help me, and Liam's going to be in kindergarten, so, you know, we need to... I'm shy. But, this is going to help me, like you said, the school supplies, and also just get him prepared, because he is the future, right? So, I really appreciate it, and I look forward to taking care of him.
Is there another parent that wants to share something about the child tax credit, their knowledge base of the benefit, or how it will help this community? Even if it's not yourself, it's a family member, because part of the message that we're receiving today is about educating the community about this benefit. Do we have one of the providers here that can help these families enrolled in the program that wants to give a quick elevator pitch about what eligibility is, the website, where you go to sign your family? Is there one here this morning? Arlene?
Hi, good morning. I'm Arlene Good, Senior Stakeholder Liaison with IRS. And I just want to say that the Advanced Child Tax Credit on IRS.gov have a portal, as was mentioned by Congresswoman Garcia. So you can go into the portal if you did not file your income tax return. There's a way for we have a non-filer tool that you can use so that you can determine if you're eligible first for the credit. A lot of new mothers may not be aware, even though they've had a child during the year, you can still be entitled to receive the advanced credit. Even though you didn't receive it for the first round, which was yesterday, we have August, September, October, November, December, so you can still receive the payment. So if you don't get it now, you still can also receive it when you file your income tax return. But please visit IRS.gov and go into the portal. We also will have some employees here from VN Temp Work that will assist you if you need assistance with that today.
So my next question to the group, and this is open to anyone: what's the next step to educate the community? What are things for the young mothers and for the providers that we as a community here in Houston need to do to ensure that everyone can receive this credit? I'll open it up.
So right now, on social media, it's a lot of misinformation about the child tax credit that under the new Biden administration, we actually have an increase. I think it's Children's Victims Honor $3,600 and all the way up to 18 is $3,000. So in reality, you actually get an increase. And it's really not going to affect, I feel like it's really not going to affect your taxes when you file your 21, because you should, if anything changed within your work status, you should still get about the same amount that you actually got for your 2020 taxes if you have filed. So there's a lot of people that just think that it's going to hurt them, but actually it's going to benefit and we actually give an increase. So our people are not educated on really like how this tax credit actually really works. They just go by word of mouth, but I think we just really need to get the word out into the community that, you know, let's break down the steps. This is how it really works. It's not really going to harm you, or you're not going to, it's just not going to affect your taxes.
Let's give her a round of applause for being educated on the process. This is what we need. Those with the knowledge base sharing their information with others. Is there anyone else? What forms of communication that you're in college there? What should we communicate to those on college there?
Like she said, to educate them on the benefits, they need to know that it's not gonna hurt. I personally have a few people that are telling me, no, don't do it because, you know, later on when it comes to file taxes, it's gonna hurt me. You know, I'm always trying to, like, I talk to people. My grandfather is very, you know, he educates me on these things. He lets me know what's gonna hurt me. He would never put me in a position where it would hurt me in the future. He's always trying to help me. So social media is one thing that we need to get one to let everyone know this is something that is going to help us and not harm us, just like she said.
So how many of you have ever had the thought, I could tell the president something and have him act on it, I would do something. So on today, we have an emissary, the president, sitting here in our midst. Thank you, sir, for your visitation. Let's give the president, whether it be an attaboy or a kudo, or a word of encouragement for his administration. So is there anyone, provider or parent, that would like to share something that we can take back to our president?
I think we should partner up with the schools. Even if it's and just be more active and let our parents know. Because I know that a lot of parents come to open house or register their school. I think that those are the times that we actually need to take the time and have a representative there to actually speak on what's going on inside, what's going to benefit them, what's going to harm them. Because right now they don't know. They're just listening to the word of mouth. And sometimes the word of mouth is not correct, you know? So I think we need to start there to benefit parents that actually have kids from the schoolhouse part, just partner with the school. And if we do that, I think it can be a great success.
I would also like to say maybe partner with the community centers, because as the world is starting to open back up, a lot of summer programs are going to be coming to fruition. And with that, the community centers need to know that information as well, so that the parents of kids that maybe aren't in school would be able to get the information as well as the help that's needed for them.
Another message for the president. So as a group, what's our next steps? This is great. This has been a great day, great event. I think we've learned, we acknowledge that this is a great benefit, that the plan is to get the information out. We have three mothers here, but what about the rest of us? What is our, I know I have a fellow veteran there. What is the benefit for those in the military? Is there anyone that knows, for veteran families that are on active duty that have children, how does this I'll open that up to the room for any of the providers. Anybody aware of what the, and one of the things of the United Way that we partner with a lot of our tax centers, Big River, the PTN, and we always get the call for a veteran that's on active duty, where does he or she go to file their taxes? So how how would this affect those in the wheelchair? Is anyone in the room aware of that? So that's something we need to educate ourselves on. That's definitely something that we need to educate ourselves on. Yes, ma'am.
Hi, I'm Kelly Hunter. I'm
that they don't know a lot of time the child tax credit. And I do give them some information about that so that they can call. And I do invite them. They know most of it cannot come. But I appreciate it very much. And for the people as our office, we can put it on the newspaper. And then we do have constituents and we can inform them what is the benefits and everything, so that they know and they take it with them. So I appreciate your work, and we appreciate the meeting today, and then I think that is a great benefit for the family with the young child and the child under 18 years old. Thank you so much, and I appreciate your work.
Thank you. I think we have an answer for our military question.
So for the U.S. military that's stationed outside the country, if their main home is still in the United States, they are still entitled to receive the advanced child tax credit. So they're not excluded, they are included.
Thank you ever so much, everyone. We have an example of how efficacious the government works. We have an HPD officer who's with us today who received his child tax credit for two children, and he received it on yesterday by way of direct deposit. Wow. I'm not going to point them out, but there are not many HPD officers in the room. So give them a hand, please.
I really appreciate everybody taking the time to sit down and have a conversation. I think the thing that I will take away from this is the idea that we should do what we know is critical, which is partnerships, partnering with schools, community centers like this one, to make sure that we get information out there. But the thing I'll also say is that some of the best information providers are mothers.
Yeah.
Know that as long as the parent has an ID number, a temporary number, and the child was born in the United States, that child can get the child tax credit. So if you know anybody who's kind of afraid because they don't know they can apply because, you know, they're not citizens, as long as the child is a citizen and they've got the temporary number, it's called an ID number, they can apply. And they can go to that portal that we're talking about and sign up. And they, you know, it may take a while before they get on, and things get straightened out, but they will get it, and the ask them to is that they started yesterday. It was the first batch. Again, it'll be coming back up in January. But we're trying to make it permanent so that as the deputy secretary said, we want to make sure that families know when the check is coming and that they can count on it. That they can count on it. It's predictable, it's every month, and it goes straight to your bank account. And Congressman, again, thank you so much for inviting me, and thank you for being here. I look forward to your next trip. Regrettably, I'm going to have to leave.
Well, thank you very much for coming. Would you give Congressman a round of applause? And I want everyone to know that our congressional offices are available. The number for my office is 713-383-9234. So if you're having difficulty, call the congressional office and maybe we can help you to get your life adjusted so that you can get this credit. This is the kind of thing that we as members of Congress do. The number is 713-383-9234. We'll be honored to help you, and if you're out of our congressional district, we'll direct you to the appropriate congressional district so that you can receive help from your congresspeople. Again, I'd like to thank our unavoidable president for being here. I want to thank all of you for being here. And I'm grateful to the press for being here and getting this message out, because this is important for us to make sure that the masses are aware of what we're doing. That's a good thing to do, great things. But if the beneficiaries, the end users, don't get the message, it's not as great as it can be. So this is a great opportunity, and I thank the press for what you're doing to get the message out. Thank you very much, everybody. And I'm going to pass the microphone now to our moderator.
Thank you all for participating in this community conversation. We're going to continue this past today. I'm going to turn the program back over to our moderator for the closing statement.
Okay. Thank you, everyone, for your attendance here and for having the conversation with you to hear some of your concerns about the advanced child tax credit. So on behalf of the Internal Revenue Service and Deputy Secretary, Congressman Green and Congresswoman Garcia, the NT work and their staff, I would like to thank you for your participation. You can go to the NT work at www.bntwork.org.